Hello, Inland Empire.
And beyond.
Worldwide.
I'm Uncle Moan.
And I'm DJ Kool Tay Tay Tay.
And you're tuned in to About That Life
Awareness Hour. Hey.
What's up? What's up, Inland Empire and beyond? We're back for another lovely Monday. I hope all you guys had a lovely, wonderful weekend. God bless each and every one of you guys out there watching in, live on KCAA Radio, listening, and on the About That Life Awareness Hour podcast. We're just here once again to try to encourage, inspire, uplift, empower somebody to get up off their do nothing and do something about changing the trajectory of their life. I'm here with my friend, close friend, one of my sandbox ninjas from back in the day, Victor Beecham from Operation New Hope. And he's been a great help. He's one of the resources that we have here on the show that God has blessed us with. And if there's anyone out there who may have had a rough time in life, rough patch, you just got out of prison, if you're an ex-felon or any of that, you guys can go down to Operation New Hope. It's on what's that?
7th Street, 323 West 7th Street, from the hours of 8 until 7:30.
Yes. All right. All right. So, go on down there and see what opportunities and they have for you. If you want to change your life, you want to do something different. You just want to be you want a career and not a job. Just go ahead and go down there. And I think that's a great segue to just talk about what today's topic will be. Like I always like to do before I start the show, for those who may be watching or listening for the first time, this show was created to inspire, encourage, empower, and just uplift someone, in some shape, form, or fashion. I don't have a bunch of rich friends. I don't have a Maserati or a McLaren. I can't show you a phone full of money. I can't talk into 50, 60 racks, but I can tell you about some of the life experiences that I have in the 5 decades plus a nickel that I've been here on this earth. Some of the things that I've experienced when I was out in the streets, when I was lost in my prodigal son moment, all some of the things that I had to learn and some of the people that took advantage of me that I know haven't changed to this day. So I just pray that the experiences that I share with you would help you in your life. And like I always tell you, I guarantee you, if you would listen to some of the things that we share here, I guarantee you will have a cheat sheet to move through life or your situations or circumstances very, very easily. I wish there was a lot of people that I wish that I would have listened to a lot of people that I came across when I was young, because I too was hard-headed. But if I can help someone not to make some of the same mistakes I make and just be on the upswing of life, that's what we're here to do. We always like to reverence those who may have lost ones, loved ones due to COVID or gang violence or any unexpected travesty. Like I always say here on this show, death is a harsh reality of life, and one day we will all have to visit it. And I'm praying that the things that I share here can help us visit it in a natural way and not no time sooner, as far as, making, the right choices and the wrong choices. And you might be able to hear E-40 in the background, and that's a part of my topic today. Is there's nothing more powerful than a made up mind and making choices. My life changed when I made the choice that I was tired of my life. I was tired of living the way I was living, and it was hard, and it'll be hard for a lot of you who may be listening, but I guarantee you can do it if you use the same tenacity and whatever it is that you're doing to make the wrong choices. If you turn the negative into a positive, I guarantee you that your life will change immensely. It's not going to be easy, but it will happen for you. We'll take a small moment of silence. I'll pray us in, and then we'll get started with the show. Lord, I just thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for this platform that you have given us. I pray that you would help us, Father God, to maybe help someone else. I pray that the things that are downloaded here today, the things that we share here today on the airwaves, will just permeate someone's heart, that it will help somebody, someone, yes, in Lord. Some shape, form, in some shape or fashion, Father God, just to change their life, Lord. I pray that you would just help us, Father God, to continue to carry on, Father God, even though some days it seems so hard. I pray that those who have lost loved ones will hold their head up high and just continue to keep on moving and know that even though things seem all bad, that you are still good. I pray that someone will get to know you from situations that happen, and that they will know that everything that you do, there's a reason for everything that you do. And Father God, I just pray for all of those who may be listening, that you would cover them, keep them safe, away from all hurt, harm, and danger, wherever they may be listening, in their cars, in their house, in their dwelling, wherever they are. In Jesus' heavenly name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, so what do you think about that, Mr. Beecham, about choices? I mean, there's nothing more powerful than a made-up mind. I think all of us, we have choices, and you can make good ones or bad ones, but when you make your mind up, you know what I mean? It's like we were talking earlier on the phone, and, you know, sometimes when somebody obviously is showing you that they made their mind up, and you're trying to help them, sometimes they might pull you out of your comfort zone, or depending on where you at, they could pull you from under your covering. Like if you're trying to get somebody to go to work and they don't want a job, or you try and give somebody a job that don't want a job, and they come to your job and mess your job up. You get them a job at your job, and a lot of times some people don't have the sense to be able to separate one person from another. They'll base your friend's work performance off of you, depending on where you at or how long you've been there. Like they say, what do they say? Association brings affiliation.
Yes.
You know what I mean? So they'll look at your friends and they'll think that you're just like them. You know, that's why they say you got to be careful who you hang around and be careful who you let in your car. And there's certain things you can't do. We got some friends that, you know, they're known for getting busy. They're known for being active. They're known for getting, you know, being out there in the way. And sometimes when you know, if you drive their car, you let them in your car, you let them drive your car. Now your car is marked and you can't take your car certain places. And I hope I didn't get too far off track, but I'm talking about ain't nothing more powerful than a made up mind. So if you make up your mind that you want to change, there's nothing that anyone can say or do to stop you from achieving your goal, from going to school, from giving your life to Christ, from studying, you know, whatever it is that you, from going to basketball practice, from, you know what I'm saying, from doing a thousand three-pointers. It just depends on, you know, what you want out of life. And also, I'm going to say this, and then we'll go to commercial and we'll come back, but I want to congratulate anyone out there who has made up their mind to change their life, who has made up their mind to move on from a toxic relationship, a toxic friendship, a job that ain't, you know, just a job, and to move on towards a career. But we'll be right back after this small commercial break.
Nope. Yeah. Ever told on a brother? Nope. Ever squeezed the trigger? Yeah. Ever set a brother up? Nope. Ever helped a brother out when he was down on his luck? You a sap? Nope. You a boss player? You a Mac? Yeah. Let me hold a couple
dollars. Company matches. Wilson taxes, yeah. Oh. No company matches. Wilson taxes, yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Wilson taxes worth the while. E smart or E foul, fastest taxes grooving. Let it be known we moving up. Register now. It's easy, affordable, smart. Receive your timely taxes. Yeah, we got that package. No company matches. It's Wilson Taxes. Yeah, no company matches. Folks staying in the federal taxes. Our product is our people. Start the day, it's all simple. No company matches. It's Wilson Taxes.
You're tuned in to the Taylon Meal Ticket Minute.
Hey, Jimmy.
Today in the studio, we have Dunamis L1019. What's up, Dunamis?
Chilling, man. What's going on with you, G?
Yeah, I know you don't have a lot of time, so we gonna get into your new single real quick. What's it called?
Church.
Do you mind if I praise him? Every sin I committed, he forgave him. So I got a shot, I got a dance in the mercy of his hands, was giving a second chance.
Church. Do you mind if I praise him?
Every sin I committed,
he forgave him.
So I got a shot,
I got a dance,
set the mercy of his hands, was giving a second chance.
So, church.
Do you mind if I praise him? Every sin I committed, he forgave him. So I got a shot, I got a dance, at the mercy of his hands, was giving a second chance. So, church.
Yeah, so where can we get this single at?
At www.thetaylinenetwork.com.
What's up, Inland Empire and beyond? We're broadcasting live here at KCAA Radio, 1050 AM, Express 106.5 FM. I guess we may be having a boss. They said that it's offline or something. Is there a problem? Something going on with that? Okay, great. Oh, great. All right. Well, whoever, if you're out there listening, if you can hear us, they're gonna check on it right now and see if they can fix that. We do have I think we're streaming on all streaming platforms too, Spotify and Pandora, a bunch of different. I think they're listening. There's no live streaming, but you can listen in on the show. If you go to KCAA Radio, this show is archived, so you can. We did multiple shows. I mean, over 150 shows. We've been doing this for almost, I want to say, about 3 years. We've been here at the station for what has it been, about 2.5 years, maybe, here at the station, or about 2.5 years. I said all I have to say is I made up my mind, and you'd be surprised about at how fast time go by when you make up your mind and you just decide that it's something that you want to do. There's nothing can stop you from doing anything that you want to do when you have your mind made up. So if you're feeling foggy about where you're at in life, make up your mind to change your life. If you're feeling foggy about the friends, or you think the friends that you're around, make up your mind to change your friends. Ain't nothing more powerful than a made up mind. A made up mind is almost like choices. It's good choices and bad choices. And sometimes in life you have to make executive decisions. Sometimes you have to resolve business partnerships that are no longer lucrative to you, that are no longer conducive to your business partnership. There's nothing more powerful than a made-up mind. And if you don't make your mind up, then you'll look up and 2, 3, 4, 5 more years than went by. You know, so I just believe in life we gotta really make up our mind to do a lot of things, you know. Okay, great. They should be up now. You can have them check again to see. But we also have a call-in number, too. That's 792-5222. Anyone out there listening, I just want you listeners out there to know that this platform is not just for me. It's for each and every one of you out there who have experienced something in life that someone out there may be able to use to change the trajectory of their life. I just feel like, and I always say it, I feel like each and every one of us that has went in and made it out, I think we owe to bring someone else out. It used to be that it takes a family to raise a village, and it seems like it's not like that anymore. It's like, bless my foe and no more. I ain't finna talk to him because he this or that. And it's like we've just gone so far away from the love that we used to have for one another. And I just hope and pray that that God will produce something, you know, before I die or leave here, that we can show that there's still some unity amongst the brethren, amongst us, so that we can make a change. There's so much stuff going on in the world right now without you making bad choices. I mean, a lot of the times if we don't stand up, they're going to make choices for us. They're going to make a choice about where we eat. They're going to make a choice about what we eat. They're going to make a choice about where we go. In a minute, they're going to make a choice about us being church. I mean, there's one Bible, and there's like over 1,000 religions. Over 1,000 religions and over more of that, different languages that people speak. I mean, it's crazy. And I'm just using that as an example because we figure that church folks are supposed to be united. But if it's one Bible, why is there so many different religions? And even without that being said, we got to make up our minds about what it is that we want to do, about where it is that we want to be in life. I mean, about, you know, if this is helping me or not. Should I continue this? Should I move? Should I change? You know, at a certain age in life, it's not conducive to be bound. It's not smart to be bouncing around on different jobs, because if you're trying to get retirement, then you want to try and be somewhere where you can grow as far as your hourly rate or whatever the case may be. And that's the whole reason for this show. I made a few bad decisions in my life. I made a few bad choices in my life. And I made up my mind to come here each and every Monday to try and help someone who may be listening not to make those same bad decisions. So I'm talking to you, young man, young woman, old man, old woman. We got to just, you know, we got to make up our minds of what we want in life. Because one day, for sure, time is a commodity that we don't have. And that's one thing for sure that we do not have. And we that's the only thing you can't get back. That's the only thing you can't get back is time. We can get back money. You can get back you can get back all the things in life, but you can't get back time, and you sure can't get back life. Once the big guy in the sky come for you, it's over. And you probably saying, well, why is he rambling on about that? I'm just saying, if you made up your mind that you don't want to stop smoking fentanyl, guess what's going to happen? One day you're going to die. If you made up your mind that you don't want to stop hitting licks or robbing banks, or you don't want to stop gang banging, it's whoop-de-wop till you die. You don't want to stop this. You don't want to stop being in a toxic relationship where he beating you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You don't want to stop being homeless or this or that, where you got bit by a brown recluse and you had to get one of your legs amputated. It may just seem like I'm just talking, but having a made up mind is an important thing in life, because if you don't know who you are, people will aspire any identity. And if you don't know what you want, people will aspire any identity on you or have you doing any and everything, because you don't even know what your mind is all over the place. You don't know what you want to do. And it's not just about, I just think that topic, it covers so many different things in our lives, because having a made up mind is also delves into the pool of making choices. You know, you got to choose to have a made up mind. And when you make your mind up, you got to choose to do the right, you know, choose to do the right, to make the right decisions once you've made your mind up. I was talking to one of my friends and he had done 10 years in the federal prison. And we were talking about choices and this and that and the other and all this other stuff. And it may seem important to you or not, but he said that when he came before the judge gave him 10 years, the judge said, you know, Mr. So-and-so, Mr. Swanson, we've seen that you've been pretty elusive. He was looking at his record and he was perusing through all of his files and stuff. And he said, yeah, we've seen you've been pretty elusive here. In 90, you got joint suspended, but you did this and that. And he said, but Mr. Swanson, I want to tell you this before I sentence you. And he said, yes, Your Honor. He said, look, you've been pretty elusive and you seem like you've been pretty good. He said, but we only got to catch you one time. We only have to catch you one time, sir. So I'm going to give you 10 years in a federal prison, blah, 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 blah. But I'm telling all you young men out there that think you got it figured out, that think you got your mind made up, that you got it figured out and you smooth and you know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody going to get you got it. All they got to catch you is one time. You got away yesterday. You got away that day. Yeah, you got a couple of bodies. You did this. You did that. Or whatever the case may be. You hitting licks. You running sprees. You doing this. You cheating on your wife. Whatever the case may be. You only got to get caught one time. That's it. And that's what the other guy too, the devil. All he got to do is catch you one time, right, and it's gonna be over. You get out there and get to moving around and do something that He's slick and he'll have you set up. And like we always say in the gospel world, be careful with sin, because it'll take you farther than you want to go, keep you longer than you want to stay. And I added this part, sometime you might not live to see another day. See, the devil is just like Jesus. He's a copycat. He's just like God, not Jesus. He's just like God. But see, you're going to reign with God in eternity. You're going to reign with the devil in hell. And it ain't going to be no raining. You're going to burn in hell forever. You know, for all you people who believe, You know, if you don't believe, just keep doing what you're doing. I mean, if God gives us free will, who am I to tell you what to do with your life? But like I say, this show was created for someone that maybe if you want to duck off and go somewhere by yourself and listen to something that's going to fire you up. And I want to encourage all the men or women who may be listening who have made choices that changed their life. I just want to encourage you and tell you God loves you and to just keep doing the right thing. And sometimes doing the right thing doesn't always feel right. Sometimes it feels like I did all this for what? You know, a lot of times I come up here and I'm talking to the wall. The phone hardly ever rings unless we call somebody. But I know in my heart, that what I'm doing is right. And I know in my heart that somewhere somebody is getting help, whether they call in or say anything or not. I know it. Like I said, I just want to encourage some of you out there who may be listening to keep doing the right thing, keep making the right choices, keep going to school, keep going to football practice, keep taking care of your son, keep taking care of your daughter, keep loving God, keep loving yourself, keep doing the right thing. There's enough negative stuff in the world that would fill up. I mean, there's more negative stuff than positive. You go on the world, you go on the internet, you can find more junk than you can stuff like this. I mean, outside of, John Gray and a lot of the other, a lot of the Christian shows and stuff like that. But I'm just saying there's more negative than there is positive, period, dot. And I just want to encourage any of you who may be listening who ever has their mind made up to do the right thing, keep doing the right thing. Keep loving your husband, keep loving your wife, keep working together, keep raising your children, keep going to school, keep studying. It, and you know what I'm saying? You riding a bus right now, but one day you're going to get a car. You might run into someone that you know that's going to carpool with you. Don't stop doing the right thing. We'll be right back after this small commercial break.
KCAA Loma Linda. The Legacy KCAA 1050 AM and Express 106.5 FM.
Taylor Swift showing up in New Jersey Sunday with quite the entourage to watch Travis Kelce and Kansas City beat the Jets. The pop star was spotted at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford cheering for the Chiefs tight end with Blake Lively, Ryan Reynolds, Hugh Jackman, and Sophie Turner by her side. Last week, the Shake It Off singer was with Travis Kelce's mom cheering on her rumored new beau. Kansas City won both games, edging the New York Jets 23-20 on Sunday. And the Swift effect also boosted Jets ticket sales by more than 18%. Pink is rearranging her fall tour dates due to health concerns. Over the weekend, the singer postponed her Texas concert, citing a severe sinus infection and the doctor's recommendation against performing. On social media, Pink apologized to her fans, saying she does everything in her power to never miss a show. She was originally scheduled to perform in Arlington September 29th, but she had to push the date back to November 26th. And Late Night TV with Jimmy Fallon, Seth Meyers, and Jimmy Kimmel all back on the air this week following the 148-day Writers Guild strike. Some good news on the concert front as Queen and Adam Lambert add more North American dates to their Rhapsody tour. Guitarist Brian May says this leg will be even more ambitious than their previous shows in the tour. The added dates begin this week in Baltimore and conclude November 11th in Los Angeles. They'll play 14 dates during the added leg of the tour. That's entertainment. I'm Liz Warner, NBC News Radio.
Was your car involved in an accident or just need help with dents? All Magic Paint and Body Collision Centers, in business for over 30 years. Their highly trained staff and certified technicians and friendly staff are the best in the business and treat each car as if it was their own. All Magic Paint and Body Collision Centers are family owned. and offer state-of-the-art equipment and tools to ensure optimum results. They use the latest technology in computerized color matching and specialize in frame repairs. With their modern laser measuring systems, they're OEM certified, and they have 4 locations to serve you. All Magic Paint and Body Collision Centers offer rental car assistance with free drop-off and pickup services too, and their work has a lifetime guarantee. All Magic Paint and Body Collision Centers are in Norco, Eastvale, Moreno Valley, and in Fontana. Call them at 1-800-61-MAGIC. That's 1-800-61-MAGIC. All Magic Paint and Body Collision Centers. 1-800-61-MAGIC. All Magic Paint and Auto Body says drive carefully.
What is your plan for your beneficiaries to manage your final expenses when you pass away? Life insurance, annuities, bank accounts, investment accounts, all require death certificate, which takes 10 days based on the national average, which means no money is immediately available, and this causes stress and arguments. Simple solution, the beneficiary liquidity plan. Use money you already have, no need to come up with additional funds. The funds grow tax deferred and pass tax free to your named beneficiary. The death benefit is paid out in 24 to 48 hours without a death certificate. You heard me right. Without a death certificate. Call us at 1-800-306-5086.
From the KCAA Weather Center, I'm Keith Maloney. Overnight, we'll have mostly clear skies with a low around 53 degrees. For Tuesday, we'll have sunny skies all day and our high temperature will be near 83 degrees. And looking at Tuesday night, the skies are going to be mostly clear. We'll have a low temperature down to around 58 degrees. I'm Keith Maloney, broadcasting live from the Tri-City Center at the 10 and 210 freeways. We are the trifecta of talk in Southern California. KCAA, 102.3 FM Riverside, 106.5 FM Redlands, and The Legacy, 1050 AM Loma Linda, San Bernardino.
KCAA invites you to join Dr. Sean Pruitt, the pharmacist on call, each Monday afternoon at 1 p.m. on KCAA. Dr. Pruitt is known as the pharmacist for the uninsured. Dr. Pruitt listens to your medical questions and he takes your concerns seriously. So tune in to Dr. Sean Pruitt each Monday afternoon at 1 p.m. right here on KCAA Radio, 1050 AM and 106.5 FM, the station that leaves no listener behind.
This is KCAA.
What's up, Inland Empire? I'm Yon. Yeah, ain't nothing more powerful than a made-up mind. You got to make your mind up that you know, you're tired of being down, you're ready for a change, or whatever the case may be. Even if you're already up, you want to go higher. If you're down, you want to get up. If you to the side, you want to move back over this way. I mean, ain't nothing more powerful than a made-up mind. And I think that a lot of us have to, you know, we just got to make up our mind. We're going to do what we want to do. And no matter what, we're gonna change our lives and we're gonna move forward in life. I think we all can do better in our lives. There's a lot of stuff that we can do better, and a lot of times we feel like if it ain't no problem, it ain't no problem. Me at 55 years old, a lot of the things that happened in my life, I just know that I ain't got all day. And like I say, time is not a commodity that all of us have. So a lot of you brothers out there, you know what I'm saying? You probably like, what is he talking about, a made up mind? I mean, what you think you got all day to be playing around? I mean, you just never know when your day gonna come. And sometime it might just, a car might just hop the curb and that'll be the end of it. My daughters called me the other day. They had a flat on the freeway and they pulled over to the edge and to the side of the freeway. They got right in and right where you get off the freeway and you go by. And when I went to go pick them up, and I immediately pulled up. I pulled up right behind them. I got right out, and I started getting busy to take the tire off. As I was taking the tire off, a highway patrol pulled up behind me, and he said, "Is you got enough air in the tire?" I said, "Yeah." He said, "Do you think you can drive off the thing?" And I said, "Yeah, I'm pretty sure I can." He said, "Well, they don't talk about it on the radio, but, you know, this is how mostly everybody get killed. They don't talk about it a lot." He said, "But I've seen more fatalities like this than anything, and they never," he said, "they don't talk about it, you don't hear about it, but a lot of people die just like this, just from changing the tire." He said, you'd be surprised. People on the phone, they veer off to the left. And it's and I've done it before, too. You fall asleep, you're coming home late from work, or you just have a brain fart. One day you're messing with that phone, and you just get kind of comfortable because you ain't had no oopsie-doos, and you drift off. But he told me that, and I said, you know what? So we got in the car, and me and my daughters and all that, and we got up off the freeway. But if you're listening, young man or brother, whoever you are, thank you. But I believe that that wasn't nothing but the grace of God, because who knows? That could have been my time. Hmm. And you know what I'm saying? That could have been my time. And I'm saying that to say we don't know when we're going to go. We don't know when we're going to go. You don't know when you're going to go. We don't know. And if the shoe don't fit, then don't worry about it. But if it's on your street, please put it on Cinderella, Cinderfella. We got to make our minds up to do, you know what I'm saying? And I'm talking to me while I'm talking to you, because I don't stand before you as a perfect man. I still be procrastinating. There's some things I need to do in my life that I ain't done, that I could do better. So this is for me, is exactly, is it, I mean, just like it's for anybody else that it may fit on their street. But there's nothing more powerful than a made up mind and choices. You got to make right choices. Mm-hmm. And ain't nobody that made a bad choice didn't know it was bad. You just figure you get away with it, or you just figure it ain't gonna be that bad. But I'm telling you, something as simple as going and punking somebody can turn into a GBA. Cause what happened if he ain't finna let you punk him? What happened if he not scared by a gun and he ain't getting out his car? What happened if he ain't the punk that you think he is? I'm just saying, and I'm using that as an example of one of the things that happens in life. What happens if he want to take the argument further than he, if, you know what I'm saying? And if you make up your mind to let certain things go, you have arguments about games, you have arguments in about different things in life. But I'm just saying, I'm using this as an example. There's nothing more powerful than a made up mind.
The power of a made up mind. I think it's something that we really have to ponder on. You asked me at the beginning of the show, what do I think about it? So I've been sitting here listening, and I believe that the power of a made-up mind controls, to some degree, the destiny of your life, the divine course in which you will travel. Because in order to have a made-up mind, you have to have focus. And when you have the focus that you need, because you have the power in your mind, you can travel through difficult times without hesitation. You go and you got your mind made up that no matter what, I woke up, I'm 10 toes down, and I'm going to make it a good day. And no matter what comes your way, as you stated, you make the right choice, because that's one of the elements of a made up mind is choice. And so if you're going to make it a good day, no matter what the haters say,
amen.
Because haters are elevators.
Amen.
It don't matter how they feel, because people going to feel however they want to feel.
Yes.
But what it's going to determine is if you're truly focused on getting through the difficult situation by the choice that you've made to determine what your outcome is going to be.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's the intent.
Mm-hmm.
It's the intent and the purpose of your life. What do you desire your life to be? You say, even changing a tire, you could be dead by someone that was distracted. But they had a choice whether they were going to check their phone while they was driving or wait till they were parked to check their phone. And you see it all day long. People drive with one hand or no hands, because some of these cars drive themselves. I couldn't be one to trust that. But they want to look at their phones, or I've even seen them playing video games when I travel across the states. They're literally playing Mario Brothers or Mortal Kombat 10 or 12 while they're on the highway at 65, 70 miles an hour.
In their Tesla.
But what I'm saying is they have a choice in that, but the intent and the focus will determine how strong your will is to stay on path to a made-up mind, because my journey, it was long and hard, and that's neither here or there because everybody got a story.
Talk about it. Talk about it.
Everybody got a story, but a time came where I had to make up my mind. Mm. And it's ironic that you use that as a topic today because there is power in that because you're not easily influenced by what the trend is or what other people are doing. Mm-hmm. You have your mind made up that you're not going back to prison.
Mm. Come on now.
So you're not going to break no more laws.
Mm. Come on.
I don't got to agree with the law.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm going to have my view based mm-hmm. on my lived experience
right,
my knowledge and my choice.
Right. Come
but
on,
I'm not going to break no laws. It's going to send me before a judge and he's going to say I'm guilty.
Yeah.
You said it. Exactly. It only takes once to catch you. Only got to catch you one time. Mm-hmm. But the power of the mind, it is greater than you can imagine. But as you begin to take control of your mind by sheer strength and focus, you begin to exercise your ability of being intentful of what you do daily.
Mm.
I'm not going to get high today. Well, don't get high today.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to sell no drugs today. Well, don't sell no drugs today.
That's right.
I'm not going to look at the rear end of these women walking by.
Come on, somebody.
Because I'm married. Well, I'm going to stay focused on what's ahead of me.
Right.
And I'm not going to be looking over my shoulder trying to find a reason to look back.
Right.
These are the things that coincide with the things that you said.
Would have made up mind
because I made up my mind over a quarter of a century ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I exercise it every day.
Right.
And I think that if more people will sit down and ponder that question for themselves as you have delivered it tonight. What strength, how much power do you have in your mind to make a goal for yourself today and be determined to get there until you reach it?
No matter what.
No matter what. Mm-hmm. That's where it lies because you can have an intent, and all you're going to have is intent if there's no application to it.
Mm.
If it ain't no focus with it, you just thinking about something.
Right.
You it's like the guy working out with real iron with some plates and wheels, and then somebody over there playing with them little cement weights. Mm. You know, as you begin to get stronger, you elevate your game.
That's right.
More you use your mind, the stronger you get in your focus. And I say this now as a older man in life.
Season. I don't like that word old.
Oh, I said older. I didn't say old.
Watch out.
Older. Now.
Okay.
Older. Hey. Yeah. Now, I know.
I tell people, you know the only way you can get older is if you die younger. If you don't want to die younger, you should be just checking out this older stuff because this is what it's all about.
That's right. But even in getting wiser, more mature, older. Mm-hmm. What I've realized is that the older I've become, the less I've listened to what somebody has to say.
Right.
I have to find out for myself.
Right.
Now, I'm not going to say that.
Depending on the source. Right?
Well, even depending on the source, you need some supportive documentation, as they say. We know if you walk out.
The word says study yourself to show approval.
Well, that's what it say. Because you need to know.
Right.
Now, we all know if you walk out in the street where cars drive and don't look both ways, you're liable to get hit.
Yeah,
that's a no-brainer.
Yeah.
But if somebody tell you, if you put a little of this with a little bit of that, and then you shake it up and you let it sit for a little while, you're going to be able to do this. Well, I need to know what a little bit of this and a little bit of that is before I shake it up and try to do anything.
So you got your mind made up that you're going to find out for yourself before you do anything.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Because when you do things in a positive manner, you get positive results.
Right.
And that's ultimately the facts of a made-up mind.
Right.
It's the power in being focused and intentful of getting clear understanding instead of jumping into a trend. And I just think that we're in a time today where if somebody say, go outside and run in the street, if enough people put on Facebook, running the streets, you won't get hit. You're going to have some folks that know the cars are in the street, and they still going to run out there and get hit.
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy because it's like even with even to the smallest degree of just scrolling on your phone every day. I mean, if you make your mind up not to do that, I mean, and this topic is not just for not just for people that's gang banging. It's for people that's living. If you got blood pumping through your veins, there's nothing more powerful than making up your mind that you wanna. We can all go higher in our life in some shape, form, or fashion. And I'm talking to me while I'm talking to you. We can all go higher. I mean, there's certain situations, and everybody's have unique circumstances and situations in their life. But we can all, there's no one that cannot benefit from making up your mind in some area. You can make up your mind that you're not going, poor blood flow in your legs. And every time you drink a certain type of drink, your legs start to cramp, your feet start to cramp. Well, if you know that, why are you drinking it? You have to make up your mind not to do it. You have diabetes and you love fried chicken and collard greens with lots of Lawry's in there and then slap your mama seasoning. But you constantly, you got gout and you like eating smothered pork chops, you know what I'm saying?
So a whole bunch of salt,
you just love soul food and this and that and the other. And I'm trying to use examples to make it as plain as possible of how I'm just not up here bumping my gums. I believe that the Spirit of the Lord download everything that I come. Cause first of all, ain't nobody doing that paying to talk to a bunch of people that ain't listening. Or they don't feel like that's not listening. So I know for a fact that if you would just take your time, and I'm talking to me while I'm talking to you, and apply some of the things that you that we share here, just into a minute. If it don't work, then don't do it again. But everybody knows it, and it's easier said than done. It's easier said than done. If you love, because a lot of people, they say they eat. Some people eat when they're depressed. Some people drink when they're depressed. Some people, they got comfort food. You know what I mean? They just love ice cream. And they already overweight. But they wobble right up in there and get them a double, triple, a chunky monkey and chocolate roll with the sprinkled dinkles on it. Or they go down there to Ben and Jerry's or go down to, what is that called? Stone Cold or Cold Stones.
Hey, man, was you watching me last night?
And run it up.
I'm just saying,
and they love their little ice cream and different stuff like that. And I'm just saying, and sometimes we got to make up our mind that, look, I want to be well. I want to be here for my grandkids. I want to watch some of us have had children later in life. And you know good and heck well that your baby, you don't know when she going to get married. And if you 50-something, you just had a child at 50-something, and she decides she don't want to get married till 30, do you got 30 years left in you? Do you? Not if you smoking PCP and smoking fentanyl or living up under the bridge or living a life that's unconducive to, you know what I'm trying to say? And I'm not being mean, but I'm just saying, not if you eating a bunch of salt and you got gout, not if you this or that, if you have health issues and you're not taking care of your health. Let me just say it that way. We have to make up our minds. It's not just me up here running my mouth. I really do believe that the Spirit of the Lord has gotten me here. I'm not, and I'm like, if it don't work for you, that's fine. But I guarantee you, I'll tell you this, like I always say, try it, you might like it. It changed my life immensely. Am I perfect? No, I'm not. No, I'm not. Do I need help? Yes, I do. Am I perfect? No, I'm not. I need help every single day, and I pray that God would help me get closer to him to make me a better husband, a better father. And there's mistakes that I made in life that I don't ever want to make them again. And I'm trying to do the best I can. And I invite positive men like this brother here, one of my great friends that we grew up together. And we've had our issues in life too, but God always bring good ones back together. And I just pray that you guys will listen to it. That we'll listen to some of the things that we share here on this show. Everything that I share here is positive. My heart is really for whoever may be listening who want to do better. And I pray that if you have anything that could help us, I welcome you. I welcome any ideas that may help us, anything that can help us to maybe help someone else that may be listening. I don't know how or what God is going to do, but I just feel like he gonna do something, whether it be here or somewhere else, because my mind is made up to continue this type of stuff until the day I die. I want to try and leave as much good here on the earth as I can before I leave here and do my best to try and make amends for some of the stupid stuff that I've done that I feel like I could have done better as a man growing up. I didn't mean to cut you off. He was talking. I'll let you finish.
Oh, no, I just was thinking about it, and I'm totally open to hear other people's thoughts, like even calling in next week. And just think about it for the duration of this week, and come next week, have an example or a response or a thought about what you've heard or what you believe the power of a made-up mind can do for you. We challenge you here at KCAA with Brother Moan, you know, Uncle Moan, you know, Dollar DJ Bill.
Cool. Take.
Yeah. And right. We just want to know, what are your thoughts? Because we need to begin a dialogue as people. Yeah. So many people have gotten away from social interaction. It's all social media. But if you look at where we fell away at the beginning of COVID and how COVID ain't going nowhere, but we still away from each other. We got to rebuild. And it takes a village to raise a child, and it takes people working together to bring out positive incomes. But it takes us to make up our mind that we're going to be supportive of one another. We're going to continue to have positive thoughts, and we're going to continue to endure the trials of life because we have the power of our mind to stay focused, and the intent is to do better. And I'll say this, you have a birth date and you have a day that you die. And I would say, which is the most important, the day you're born or the day that you return from which you came? Well, neither of those can be changed. You're born on the day that you take your first breath of air, and you're going to die the day the Creator calls you home. But what will you do with the dash in the middle? How will you be remembered? Will you create a legacy? Or will you be a part of the negativity of this world? You have to make that decision. If each one helped one, we'd all be better off. Just one. Just try helping one person and being positive and being there to support one person and see what it does for you internally. It's a humanitarian right to receive help from another. And we shouldn't be holding it back from each other.
Most definitely. Most definitely. Yeah, I just love each and every one of you who may be watching, and all of the ones of you who log on and check us out and just listen to the things that we share here. God bless each and every one of you, and my heart goes out to you. And there's nothing more, like I said, there's nothing more powerful than making up your mind that you're ready for a change in life, that you say you want to be a nurse, that, okay, you made up your mind that you're going to go to nursing school until you finish. You made up your mind that you're not going to go out clubbing or hanging out. You want to be a doctor, or you want to be the best three-point shooter, so you're going to do 1,000 three-pointers a day. You want to be the biggest bodybuilder, so you're dedicating yourself to going to the gym. You want to lose weight, so you stop. You're on a water diet or a fruit diet. But there's nothing more powerful than a made-up mind, and there's no smoke intended towards anyone. I hope I did not offend anyone, and a lot of things I share here are the things that some of the things that bewilder me, some of the things that I suffer with, is making up my mind. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes sometimes you're double-minded. You say this and then you do that, or you want to do this, but you're thinking about the outcome of what might happen, or you want to say this and you don't want to say it because you don't know what's going to happen. And a lot of times we got to just make up our mind that, you know, whatever happened is going to happen. It's something that I need to do. is something that needs to be done. And then also goes and falls into the realm of making executive decisions. Sometimes in life, we got to, having a made up mind comes down to the fact of us making executive decisions. We got to, you know what I'm saying? We just got to change. Sometimes you might have a job that's just draining the life out of you. And as bad as you need the money, it's tearing you down physically. It's messing you up emotionally. Your sleep is all over the place. And I'm just using that as an example. And sometimes you might have to make an executive decision that I'm going to have to get a job where the hours are a little bit more better for me. I work a graveyard shift and I own my own business, and it's tough. But because of the choices that I made earlier in life, because of me making up my mind early in life that I wanted to run the streets and sell drugs and marijuana and move around and not build a future or a career for myself where I don't have to work one job and get a substantial enough of income where I didn't have to work five jobs till my eyes bleed or pop out my head or I look like I've been drinking all night. This is the result of it. So I'm praying that some of you that may be listening or will listen to the things that I have. And then also, if you have parents that love you, that will allow you to stay, and all they want to see is you do good, and they allow you to stay under their roof, and all you got to do is do good, what is wrong with you? Take your butt to school. Go get you a job. Get your life together. That's an advantage. And I've run into so many children that got it good, and they're out there cuckoo for Cocoa Puff, stuck on stupid. If you got parents that love you, especially if you got two of them parents and a family, I mean of uncles, and all they want to see you is do good, I say shame on you. Shame on you. And I don't know who you are, but get yourself together. Get yourself together and get out there and dust yourself off. We all make mistakes. Dust yourself off. Pick yourself up and make your mind up that you're going to change for the better. If you don't have a $30 an hour job, guess what? I mean, education, you're not going to get a $30 an hour job. Work with what you got. Work with the 16 or 15. Do what you can. Make the necessary sacrifices. What is a violation? A penitentiary violation is what, about 3 months, 90 days, depending on what it is?
Well, yeah, according to what it is, you can get a year or file a new charge on you.
Okay, you can get a trade school degree, the minimum amount of one is 6 months. You can be a truck driver in less than 4 months. You can go get your truck driving license at CR England or any of these new truck driving schools. They'll you can be in the truck moving around, and if you want to get out the way, that is a perfect way to get out the way. You can be moving around making up to $700 to start, $700 a week or $800 a week to start. If you live in the truck, you'll just be stacking and stacking and stacking. For those of you who don't have children, or if you don't have any parents or anyone that you know that you can, you know, where you can lay your head, that's a great opportunity, because you can live in the truck and stack all your money, right? I know a lot of people that do that. I know a lot of guys that are team drivers, them and their wife. I mean, you can make, and once you get acclimated with it and you get your experience, I know guys making $2,000 a week just driving trucks locally. So I'm just saying that you got to build, and you got to make up your mind that you want to build something, whatever it may be. You got to start somewhere, and you got to make up your mind to change. Young man, young lady, man or woman, it's time for us to make up our minds that we want to change and we want to move forward in life. Well, whatever the case may be, we got to do better. Amen. Father God, I thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for just allowing me to share what you have given me with the people who may be listening. I pray that in the future, Father God, that this will be an interactive show, that people will call in far and wide, Father God, and we would touch the hearts and the lives of people all over the world, Father God. And I know that you are working. Even though I can't see it, you're working. I know that you're touching someone's heart, and someone's heart was touched tonight. So I pray that you will bless each and every one that takes time out to just log on and hear what we're saying. I pray that you will bless them immensely, Lord God. I pray for their families. I pray for their life. I pray for their health. I pray for their whole situations, Father God. I pray for healing for those who need healing. I pray for deliverance for those who need deliverance, Father God. I pray for all of their unique situations that you will bless them immensely, Lord God. In Jesus' heavenly name we pray. We thank you, we praise you, and we'll see each and every one of you next Monday if you choose to log in. God bless you. Peace.
KCAA Loma Linda. The legacy KCAA.